Hey folks, Sardar here, and today on Dev with Sardar, I'm going to demonstrate a new experimental tool for all-in-one Python project management, a tool called RYE. Many languages like Rust and Go have single command tooling that handles everything from setting up a new project to updating its dependencies. Python doesn't have anything like that out of the box, but third parties have been putting together tooling for Python that works like that. And one such project is RYE. RYE was developed by Flask creator Armin Ronecker to manage his projects. It combines several tools used for managing Python projects into a single executable written in Rust. It's still experimental, but it's worth trying out if you want to find one possible way to streamline your Python workflow. So here I'm going to give you a look at RYE in action. I've already installed it on this system, and like the tooling that inspired it, it's self-updating. So I can use the RYE self command to check if RYE itself needs any updates and apply them. Now, let's say I want to start a new project with RYE. And for that, I would go to a place where I want to create a new project directory like this. And I would type RYE init and a project name. And this creates a directory with that name and populates it with the scaffolding that we need for a modern Python project, like a pyproject.toml file, a placeholder readme, a little placeholder code, and so on. It also gives us a git repository and a gitignore file, so we don't have to initialize those ourselves either. Now, a really important thing RYE can do for you is save you the trouble of having to set up Python itself. When you set up RYE, and you create a project, it will fetch a pre-built copy of the Python interpreter from a third-party repository, the Python standalone builds repository. And this is really useful on systems where specific editions of Python aren't even offered in a binary format. So I don't even need to have the Python runtime installed on the system. I can just fetch RYE. RYE will fetch its own copy of the runtime and will set that up whenever I start a new project. I will say that there are some quirks associated with these standalone Python builds. They mostly involve input at the Python REPL, so I encourage you to read up on that and experiment a little bit before making a commitment. But this can be a huge time saver. First thing we typically want to do when we start a new project is set up some dependencies. So we can use the RYE add command for that, and that adds dependencies to our pyproject.toml file. And then we use RYE sync to synchronize the project's definition to its current state. This makes sure all the needed dependencies are installed and ready. And by the way, if we're adding dependencies that are dev-specific, we can just use the dev flag to do that, for instance, with black. You'll also notice that in the version file that is associated with our project, that's a note about which version of Python is to be used with this project. So if you have to remove and recreate the virtual environment, you will get the same Python version used with it. And this is also another useful thing that RYE can do for us. It can allow us to use different versions of Python side by side quite seamlessly. Now, when you set up a project with RYE, it will add sections to pyproject.toml, which are labeled with tool.RYE. Don't touch these manually. RYE will handle those. And also, when you add requirements, RYE will generate lock files for your dependencies. Again, don't edit these. RYE itself will make changes to dependencies as you need to. You just need to remember to run RYE sync after changing dependencies to bring the state of your project up to date. So when you want to build a wheel for your project, you can just use RYE build, and the corresponding wheel will get built in a dist subdirectory. And you can use the dash dash clean flag when you want to build using a completely refreshed build environment. And finally, when you want to publish the results to PyPI or some other compatible repository, you can just use RYE publish. I can't fully demonstrate that part here because I don't have something complete I can push to PyPI, but the idea should be pretty plain. So as you can see, almost all the meta management that you need to perform for a Python project can be done through the command line with RYE by way of this one executable. And the biggest advantage of this is that it includes obtaining and setting up Python itself. This is something that often adds complexity to Python projects, just getting Python in and running. Now, again, all this is still pretty experimental, so you will want to give RYE a first shot using some non-production code, or at least something that you can work with production in a highly controlled way. But do give it a try. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sardar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.